Dearly beloved, we've come together in this garden in the presence of God to witness and to bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. And that bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned that manner of life by his presence, the first miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And marriage signifies to Christian people the mystery of the union between Christ and his church. And Holy Scripture commends marriage to be honored by all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it's God's will for the procreation of children. And therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. And into this holy union, Cristina Ann Romeo and Scott David McLafferty now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be joined together, speak now or else forever, hold your peace. Cristina, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And Scott, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And will all of you who are witnesses to these vows and promises do all in your power to uphold Scott and Cristina in their life together? Okay, not everybody's on board. Okay, we're asking for your support for Scott and Cristina. Do all of you support them in their decision to love? Okay. That's what we like to hear. And who gives this woman to be married to this man? He's going to leave, so give him a big hug now. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, you've created us all, male and female, in your image. Look down mercifully upon this man and this woman who come seeking your blessing. Assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they honor and keep the promises and vows they make. Amen. You may all be seated. And at this time, I'd ask for the groom's brother, Ryan, to come for a reading.
Sooner or later, we begin to understand that love is more than verses on Valentine's Day or romance in a Hollywood film. We begin to know that love is here and now, real and true, and the most important thing in our lives. For love is the creator of all our favorite memories and the foundation of our fondest dreams. Love is a promise that is always kept, a fortune that can never be spent, a seed that can flourish in even the most unlikely of places. And this radiance that never fades, this mysterious and magical joy, is the greatest treasure of all, one known only by those who love and are loved in return.
They say they will love, comfort, honor each other to the end of their days. They say they will cherish each other and be faithful to each other always. They say they will do these things not just when they feel like it, but even, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, when they don't feel like it at all. In other words, the vows they make could hardly be more extravagant. They give away their freedom. They take on themselves each other's burdens. They bind their lives together. The question is, what do they get in return? They get each other in return. There will always be the other to talk to listen to. There is still someone to get through the night with, to wake into the new day beside. When they have children, they can give them, as well as each other, roots and wings. They both still have their lives apart as well as a life together. They both still have their separate ways to find. But a marriage made in heaven is one where a man and woman become more richly themselves together than the chances are either of them could ever have managed to become alone.
Well, Cristina, Scott, finally, today is the day, a day that you've looked forward to and have been planning for many months. I don't know if you all realize, the guests that are assembled here, that today 40% of couples find each other online. eHarmony, match.com. And I've learned as a priest for 32 years, and we do 200 weddings here a year at the monastery, I've learned that the better educated a couple is, the more likely they are to have deal breakers. Like you told me, smoking, but a deal breaker. Because you know what you want. You knew what you were looking for. The funny thing is that you guys live two blocks apart from each other. And it took the computer to find each other. Now, some people would say that's fate. In the church, we say it was meant to be. I love it that after you guys met, you kept running into each other in the neighborhood. You'd both been there right in front of each other all along. But once you'd met, now you noticed each other. Well, you met briefly for drinks. It ended up, as they say, the rest is history. Now, I want to remind all of you that Cristina and Scott are not making a commitment today. We all know that commitments are made in private moments with only two people when you decide, I want to spend the rest of my life with you. Even your romantic engagement. Scott, you surprised her Christmas Eve with your, not this last Christmas, but the Christmas before. You have everybody all together for your family. They're all in on it. You told them we'll stage family pictures so there's cameras to record the moment. And that's when you got your ring. But even that was not the commitment. And even today is not a commitment. What we recognize is you have already made a commitment in the heart. And what you do today is ask God's blessing on that commitment that you've already made. This is a public ritual. And then you ask your family and friends to say a little prayer for you as you start out your life together. Now, you could have been married anywhere. I mean, you guys have, I mean, Monday, you're leaving on a pretty swell trip to spend your honeymoon in Napa. And even though you've already been to Italy, you're going back again in May. And both of those places, Sonoma and Napa, all the places you've traveled all over the U.S. together, many of them would have been great destination wedding places. But you've chosen to be married here and with people that you love and care about. This place is a sacred place, a holy place. I think all of you know that it was built in the 12th century, in 1133, almost 900 years ago in Spain, and it was brought over here, 35,000 stones, some of them weigh a ton and a half. And tonight, as you sit, eat, dance, drink, and enjoy this evening, you'll be under those walls, those arches. We always say around here, if these walls could talk, what secrets and stories they could tell. But for almost 900 years, 885 to be exact, this chapel behind me has been a place of worship. It's here people bring their dead to mourn them before they're buried. It's here they bring their children to baptize them and dedicate them to God. This is where young Latina girls come in their tiaras for their quinces and to dance. This is a place where week after week, people receive the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. And couples like you come to have their marriages and weddings blessed. But it's not just about a pretty place or even a holy place. But around you are your family and friends. These are the people that matter the most to you, the people that you love and care about. And it's your shared values and the same future that you both envision and want together. You've both told me how much you value family. Today we have right here on the table behind me a little bouquet of flowers with a rose for your mother. Very appropriate for Mary Rose to have that here. That's a reminder of that presence that you carry with you all the time, because you are who you are because of your parents, both of you. Well, Cristina, you've been through some things together with Scott. You know what an overachiever she is. She went into a mode when we had our hurricane here in Florida. She booked 3 flights for Scott to make sure that he could get out of this state safely when she was evacuated. Now, everybody did make fun of you for making 3 bookings, but it's you that had the last laugh because the first 2 got canceled and he was able to make it on the 3rd. Of course, you know, Scott's reaction to all this, what, you couldn't get a direct flight? But so many sweet, sweet things. Before you made that move all the way across the country in June, you were sick as a dog, fever 101. Scott comes over to finish packing for you, well, because you just really couldn't get out of bed. You've already been there for each other. You've come a long way, too. I mean, Scott, when you first started going over, she had to put her cats on Prozac. Now, I think they've decided you're a keeper. Now, we all know that they could have had many more guests here. People from not just Philadelphia, but school, your internship, your past lives and incarnations. But you've invited the people who matter the most to you to be here. Tonight, there's going to be music and drinking and dancing and a real celebration. But for a few moments, I'm going to ask you to say publicly what you've already said privately, and to ask your family and friends to join me in a little prayer, asking God's blessing on your life together. They're all here to hope with you, to support you, and they're proud of you, and to remind you that love isn't always happily ever after. And it's not just one moment. It's not even this moment. It's every moment. It's those big moments, like saying I love you, moving in together, getting engaged. But it's mostly a million little ones that come between those big moments. Falling asleep next to one another, making dinner together, spending holidays with your families. Those are the everyday moments that fuse into that big experience that we call life and marriage. So I'm going to ask you now to turn and face each other and join hands. And remember this moment. Because before this moment, you've been many things to one another. An acquaintance, a friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you've learned much from one another in this almost 3 years. But now you're going to say some words that are going to take you across a threshold, and things are never going to quite be the same between you. Because after these vows, you're going to say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. Now, Scott, if you'll repeat after me. I, Scott, take you, Cristina.
I, Scott, take you, Cristina.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
And now, Cristina, if you'll repeat after me. I, Cristina, take you, Scott.
I, Cristina, take you, Scott.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
Bless, O Lord, these rings and the vows by which this couple bind themselves to each other.
Scott, if you'll place this on Christina's ring finger and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I cherish you.
And cherish you.
And repeating after me, Cristina. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I cherish you.
I cherish you.
Oh.
And being Church of England, you've all heard the expression, we're going to go to the church to tie the knot. And that's where this comes from. You're probably also familiar with the phrase, I'm going to ask for her hand in marriage or take her hand in marriage. And that comes from this ritual right now. And so I ask for you all to stand. And as I literally bind them together, please join me in the prayer that Christ taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Now and forever. Amen. Now that Scott and Christina have joined themselves to each other with the giving and receiving of rings and the profession of vows, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God joins together, let no one put asunder. Amen. You may kiss your bride.
It turns out you weren't even a- invited, man.
And at this time, we're going to invite all of our guests to find us.
How sweet it is to be loved by you. I needed the shelter of someone's arm. There you were. Needed someone to understand my ups and downs.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for our beautiful bride and her very proud father. At this time, I'd like to invite the groom onto the dance floor, and I'd like to invite his mom to join him, as they will share a very special dance to a song entitled, Because You Love Me.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you, I'll be forever thankful, baby.
Of family bonds. Though we all lived far apart, all of our parents made sure that we grew up together, largely on the beautiful and exotic beaches of the Jersey Shore. Even when that meant driving 12 hours in a car with toddlers. But the bonds that we developed on those family vacations are more that of siblings than of cousins. And Cristina lives that value of family bonds every day and serves as a leading example of it. But when I say family, I mean that in the larger and more inclusive sense. As all you who know her can attest, when you meet Cristina, you become part of her family, and she will do anything for you and drop everything to help you in a time of need. Because that is what makes Cristina special. That is the kind of person she is. Someone who cares deeply for others and always puts others before herself.
So because Cristina is such an amazing woman, I knew that when she told me about 6 weeks after she and Scott started dating that she had met someone and that she was, in her words, over the moon for him, I knew that he had to be something really special too. So we,
yeah, that's right, yeah.
Our family first met Scott 2 years ago at our family's Christmas Eve gathering. As you can imagine, this gorgeous doctor makes a very good first impression. So, at the end of the evening, our Aunt Terry stood up and announced that she was giving him a grade of A+, because In addition to being very close, our family is also just really loud and irreverent, and we do ridiculous things like grade each other's new boyfriends to their faces upon initial introduction. But since we were, you know, apparently playing this game, I felt the need to step in, because it seemed like a little bit much to me, so I said, whoa, A+, I don't know about that. I said, maybe A- B+, let's not give it all away up front here. But I have to say, in the last 2 years, we've seen this amazing couple show their commitment to each other and to their relationship, and we heard so much about these wonderful commitments to each other in that gorgeous ceremony today. And our family has witnessed the two of you support each other through such exciting professional changes for the two of you, and a move from Philadelphia to Miami, and surviving a hurricane. And Scott has even embraced Christina's two feline loves, Lila and Huey Lewis, which is pretty adorable. So Scott, I have to say, 2 years later, I'm finally ready to give you that grade of A+. And I know we are all so happy, so thrilled to be welcoming you into our family, where now you have earned the right to pass judgment on any potential future family members, along with the rest of us.
So, Christina and Scott, I'm going to be honest. My role in all of this is to give you your first piece of marital advice. So the first thing I want to do is apologize for the fact that I'm your first piece of marital advice. With that said, rather than give you advice, what I'd like to do is just share with you, so far, things about my experience that I have loved. The first one being gratitude. Gratitude goes a really long way, but not just for the really obvious things, right? For all the little things that people don't talk about. So, for example, when you're home and you hear a key in the door and you've had a long day and you know that key belongs to your other half, then you realize there's nobody you would rather see walk through that door at that particular moment. Or when you've had a really long week at work and you have these big plans for an amazing Friday night, and those big plans turn into pizza, a bottle of wine, and just sitting on the couch in front of the TV. And for a moment, you realize there is nowhere you would rather be. That's all the little stuff that people don't talk about that so far has been my absolute favorite part of being married to my very best friend. So with that, we want to wish you guys a long, long lifetime of happy, amazing little moments that only you guys know about, but will happily share together for a long time to come. We love you both very, very much. We're honored to be here, and we hope you have a great rest of the night. Cheers.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies, great job on that speech. That was awesome. It was funny. It was true. It was to the point. My name is Mark. I'm actually Scott's older brother. A lot of people think that I'm his younger brother. Maybe the 2-foot difference in our height makes that hard to believe. But I'm his older brother. And, you know, over the last couple weeks when I was taking a few minutes out to figure out what I wanted to talk about today, I ran through different scenarios and I landed that I thought that it was most important to speak to their character. And I wanted to say more than words, and how am I gonna express this? And the one way that I was able to figure out to do that is just to take a moment and figure out who's in this room right now and how far people came. What are we talking about? Washington State, California, Texas, New York, New Jersey, Boston, Pennsylvania, China, England. That guy's from England. People have come very far, and I tie that back to only their character to do that. They are great individuals. I'm so happy that you two met. I know my brother very well. Scott, you know you're my best friend. Since they met, I could tell that he is incredibly happy, and this is definitely the right move. And Christina, I know you did a ton of work to get us here. You look outstanding. This place is amazing. I'm sure the food's going to be great. I'm just ecstatic for what you guys have going on and where your future's going, and I'm just honored to be standing here right now doing this speech. So if we could just take a quick moment, raise our glasses to Cristina and Scott, a lifetime of happiness. Let's all have a great time tonight. Cheers. Cheers, everybody. Cheers. Love you guys. Love you guys.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. Is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. Is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two. Love can't make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you.